Hello, everyone. Hopefully you're enjoying your virtual 2020 JNUC so far. My name is Chaz, and today we'll be going over a demonstration and a keynote for creating and deploying packages with Jamf Now. Again, my name is Chaz. I'm a technical support engineer here at Jamf, and mainly what I do is I own and handle escalated Jamf Now cases and support. Today's agenda, we'll be going over what a package is, package deployments, requirements, and resources. We'll also create and sign a package with Composer in a demonstration form. We'll also upload and deploy that package that we create using Composer, and then we'll observe package installation. So let's dive into it. What is a package? Chances are, as a Mac user, you've probably interacted with or used packages at some point in time in your Mac usage career. Package is a common macOS file type that can be used to install files and scripts on Macs. And as a Jamf Now admin, you can utilize packages to deploy things like applications, scripts, printer drivers, and many more. Really, there's a bunch of different ways you can utilize packages to deploy content to your Mac, and it's up to you to kind of choose how you wanna utilize packages to deploy that. So package and using Jamf Now to deploy these packages, it's important to go over the requirements and resources to deploy packages and create them as well. You'll need a Jamf Now Plus subscription. Jamf Now Plus is the escalated tier of your Jamf Now account that you can upgrade to that gives you access to different features and capabilities that the Jamf Now standard plan does not have. The main feature that we'll be going over today is the ability to create and deploy packages. And then along with your Plus account, you'll actually get access to Jamf Composer as well, which comes free with your Jamf Now account. Composer is a tool that is used to create the package. And your last requirement is an Apple developer account membership. And what that gives you access to is a signing certificate that allows you to sign packages for deployment. Now let's dig into the demonstration today. That's going to be the majority of this presentation. It's a demonstration of building and signing packages. I should be sharing my screen now. First place that we'll want to navigate to is login.jamfnow.com. This will be the login page for your Jamf Now account. You'll enter in your credentials. We'll hit login. And once logged in, we'll want to navigate to our account tab to make sure that we're on the Plus subscription. As you can see, I'm on standard. We'll go ahead and upgrade to Plus. You'll get to see all the benefits of Plus when you go through this upgrade process, and we'll hit change plan. And now we are on Jamf Now Plus, and we can see our plan includes Jamf Composer for Mac at no cost to you. To download Composer, all you have to do is hit learn more. You get hit with this landing page where you get this description of Composer. You'll also get access to this Composer user guide, which I'd recommend saving somewhere on your computer as it's a very valuable resource for a product. Pretty much it's a product breakdown of Composer and how to use it. So just having that handy will be beneficial. And then we'll just also go ahead to and download Composer on this page as well. So this will take a couple seconds to download. And once complete, we'll go through the installation process and let's begin installation. Here's Composer. We always recommend to drag and drop Composer to your applications folder just to make it more accessible for you as an admin. Drag it into your applications folder, and now we have Composer living in applications. So we'll go ahead and open up Composer. We'll allow for it to open. We'll enter in our admin password. And first screen that you get met with when opening up Composer is Composer telling you, hey, I need full disk access to do what I need to do to create your packages. So we'll go ahead, we'll go into system preferences. We'll unlock system preferences, which will allow us to add Composer and grant Composer full disk access. So, and anytime you make a change under the security pane, of system preferences, you'll need to restart the application, which I just did quit now. And now Composer will have full disk access. So when I go to build a package, it can access any files and folders on my Mac to build said package. So go ahead and delete this lingering file on here to kind of give you the full breakdown. But once we get access to Composer, we see Composer. And in this demonstration, what I'll be doing is creating a Firefox package for deployment to this test machine in front of me. You may want to deploy Firefox to your Macs if your users need Firefox. And it's important to package it because it's actually not available in Apple's Apple Business Manager portal as a licensed app that you can deploy. So the only way you could really install Firefox is either through packaging it and deploying it to your Macs, or having users go and manually install it, which may not be desired. So best way to deploy it to your Macs is through packaging. So I have Firefox existing in my applications folder right here. What I'm going to do is drag and drop Firefox into Composer. This converts Firefox into a source. And so you can see kind of all the components of Firefox within Composer that are going to be built into this package. Important things to note is if Firefox requires some sort of special files to be included along with it that are unique to your organization or your needs in this deployment, you can always edit the files of Firefox yourself. Such, you know, a common one that's edited is info.plist. If you know what you're doing and you're able to reference Firefox documentation that may note of different ways that you can customize the application, you can edit it here. And then when you drag it into Composer, those edits will be saved within the Firefox.app file itself. So just kind of a pro tip to have in your back pocket. But yeah, we dragged and dropped Firefox into Composer. It's now converted as a source. We're almost ready to package it. The final step that we'll want to do is jump into the menu, and we'll want to check preferences to see how this package is being signed. Again, one of those requirements for deploying packages is an Apple Developer Certificate. And that certificate signs your package. So when you deploy it to your Mac, it'll actually install because it's a requirement. If you're missing a signing certificate, A, Jamf Now will just throw you an error saying you can't upload this. And B, if we were to allow you to upload it and deploy it, it would just error out because it's an MDM requirement is a signing certificate. So under this location, you'll want to make sure sign with is clicked, and you'll want to make sure you see your developer certificate here. And this list right here is just pulled from the login items of your keychain. So prior to any of this building, you'll want to reference the resource included in our handout that is that accompanies this presentation. And in that handout, there's a workflow that just details how you'd go about creating and saving a signing certificate to your Mac. I'm not going to be demonstrating that in this presentation, but if you have any issues with that, don't hesitate to reach out to support and we'll help you out in creating that and saving that signing certificate. But as long as it's in the login items keychain, Composer will recognize it. You'll see it in this drop-down list, and you'll be able to select it to sign it. And it'll read as developer ID installer and then your name. So I'm not going to click sign with because I don't have access to a developer certificate for this demonstration, just due to us not having access to that in support. It's owned by our IT department. So I actually signed a different package that we'll be using to test deployment with after we create this instance of this Firefox package. So we have the application that we want to deploy. We confirm that it's checked with sign with and our developer ID installer. That means we're ready to create this and turn this into a package. So we'll go ahead, we'll hit build as package. We'll choose where we want to save it. We're going to be saving it to our desktop. And this will begin the process of building a Firefox package. And we'll let this do its thing. Don't hesitate to be asking any questions that you may be getting as you're watching this presentation. We'll be addressing them at the end of this presentation as well. So let's take a look at Finder, and now we can see our Firefox package that we just created today at 9:49, which is right now. And it's saved to the desktop as we selected it to be. Awesome. One plug that I want to give for a third-party application that we use here daily in support is Suspicious Package. What this does is allow you to inspect both packages that you create yourself as well as packages that you get from the internet and inspect them and see kind of how they're built and whether they have an accompanying signing certificate. Essentially, they just allow you to do an overhead view of a package to make sure all the necessary items are being met to allow for deployment. So we can see that it is signed by developer ID installer, Jamf software. This is the one that I created ahead of time. This isn't the one that I just created in Composer. We can see in all files, it has the same structure as the one that we saw in Composer. Doesn't have any scripts in it. Pretty bare bones package with just the Firefox installer. And we can see it has 152 items, which are all these items under here. So yeah, mainly suspicious package is valuable for packages that you get off the internet, because then you could confirm that yourself since you didn't create it yourself. So, and it's also suspicious package is a free application too. Forgot to mention that. We'll have it in the download link in the handout as well. So if you wanted just a tool that we use and support available to you for whatever testing you need to do, you'll have the download link for that. And we recommend that, you know, at a minimum, you download and just have access to it. So closed suspicious package, we're good on that. We have our package created. We technically can close Composer. I'll just have it open in the background. And the final step is uploading the package that we just created into Jamf Now. And to do so, we'll click on the Apps tab right here. We'll click on Add an App. We'll click on Upload Your App. And we'll go ahead and upload. You can either drag and drop or browse for it on your computer. And we'll click Upload into Jamf Now. The upload process is going to take about 2 minutes based on my previous test. And during this time, I thought it'd kind of be important to drive home the differences in ways that packages can be obtained for deployment. One is you build and sign the package yourself. We just went over that in Composer and what that looks like. The other way that is pretty common too is just getting a package from the internet, whether that's from directly from a developer's website or through, you know, whatever means that you grab the package from. It's common to have packages that you can try to upload directly into Jamf Now to deploy to your Macs. The thing is, you'll want to make sure that the package is built correctly to allow for Jamf Now deployment. The two main things that you're going to want to confirm are, is the package that you installed from the internet signed? And you can use suspicious package to confirm that. The other thing you'll want to confirm is the package created for distribution? And it's unfortunate, but really the only way that you can confirm that it's intended for distribution is to test deployment yourself. So all you need to do is upload it into your Jamf Now account and then test deploying it to a singular test machine and see what results you get. The main error that you'll want to look for is the file distribution is not found. And I'll be going over in a second where you'd see that error. If you were to test deployment and you were to, you know, the package wasn't created for deployment. So I'll be showing that in a second. And then also one final point I can mention is if you are suspecting that you're running into a package that isn't intended for distribution, always feel free to reach out to support. We can test deployment ourselves as well and let you know what we find when we deploy the package as well. So I'll call this package Firefox V7.71.0. That is the actual build of Firefox that we uploaded into Jamf Now. And this is a good way as you as an admin can differentiate what versions of Firefox that you have uploaded. Because if you, say, for instance, want to deploy version 72.0 when that comes out and you aren't confident in your end users updating that packet or that application themselves, you can just upload V72.0 into Jamf Now and then scope that new package to the Apps tab of the blueprint. But we got our package named. We have it V71. We'll click Done. And now we can see the package is a part of our apps library, which is awesome. And now really the only final thing left to do is to try deploying it to the Mac that I'm currently signed in on. Or using, I should say. So I'll open up console. Console is just like an application that comes pre-installed on Mac. The filter words I filter by are MDM and install, if I can type. And what this will do is just filter out all the random logs that are being generated by the Mac and show us the install application command for the package that we're about to send to this computer. So this allows us to see the process is happening in the background when the Mac receives this command. It's going to be silent it's going to be a silent experience for the end user, unless the installer requires some additional, you know, key or some sort of code that's associated with the app. Then it'll prompt when the package tries to install. But if it's a package that just, you know, has you click next a bunch, approve it, and then install it, it's going to happen all silently in the background for the Mac. So since Firefox will be a silent install, we'll have console open to view the logs that'll be generated. So we have Firefox in our app library. We have console open on this Mac that we're signed in on. Last thing to do is add the package to the apps tab of the blueprint. As you can see here, I have this test MacBook Pro that I'm using right now for this demonstration associated with this Composer JNUC demonstration blueprint. Last thing to do is hit add an app. You will go ahead and add the Firefox package that I just added. One thing that I almost screwed up is I'll want to remove Firefox actually from here first to make sure that you can see it install. I'll try my best to see if I can leave this open right after I scope it, so you can make sure that I'm not tricking you that it's being deployed. So just added it to the apps tab of the blueprint. This is what the user experience will be. We should see Firefox pop up here any second. And when it does, we'll also look at the console and then see the logs that are being written there, just to kind of show you both sides, both the user experience and then what's going on in the background of the Mac. So it did receive it. I'm probably going to miss it being installed if I tab away from it. But we can see if I can somehow minimize this. There we go. So we can see that the scheduled install application command was received right here at 56, so about a minute ago. And I think it just popped up. Yeah, we can see it right now in applications. This command is the command that Jamf Now sent that says, hey, computer, install this package from this location. And you can see the URL where Jamf Now is storing this package. A lot of this other logs, all these other logs are kind of, you know, they're kind of fluff. But the main one that you care about is this scheduled install application from the location of the package. This is also where you'd see that distribution error that I was mentioning when uploading the package. If you're uploading a package that's not intended for distribution, if you're filtering via this, you'll see the package distribution does not exist, which is how the error reads. And if that's the case, the person who created that package did not create it with MDM deployment in mind. So what you'll just have to do is just drag that package to Composer and essentially rebuild it and re-sign it with your developer certificate. And Composer by default builds all packages as distribution packages. So if you create a package in Composer, it's going to be created for Jamf Now deployment. Perfect. So we see the log. We saw Firefox appear here as installed. That is what we wanted to see. And that is, you know, the end of the demonstration that I had for you today. So I'll bring it back to the slides that we have. And yeah, I just wanted to say thank you for attending this JNUC session on deploying and creating packages with Jamf Now. Again, there'll be a handout that'll be accompanying this presentation. So reference that for a lot of valuable information and links that you can use. You don't have to search them on the internet. You can just check that reference and view those links there. Again, also too, Jamf Now support will be here to help you out with creating these packages. So if you're running into any issues or you're not seeing packages install the way that they should, the support will be here. And then also the Composer user guide too is also a valuable tool to just make sure that you're following the best practices noted in that user guide. So again, I appreciate everyone's time today for taking time out of their day to learn about packages, deploying packages, creating packages, all that stuff. I appreciate your time. And I hope that you have a good remainder of JNUC. And if I don't hear from you in support, have a good remainder of the summer into fall. So have a good rest of your day. Thank you.